You know in the first Jurassic Park movie, there was that scene with the glass of water in the car's cup holder with ripples on it to show just how heavy the approaching T-Rex's footsteps were? Well, this thing behind me is technically called the Large Mobile Shaker, but the folks here at the University of Texas, they call it the T-Rex because it's a machine designed to shake the ground itself.
We have 5 shakers. They go from a small one that's right behind me, and we call that an urban shaker because you can bring it downtown and not get into trouble shaking. And then we have very, very large ones, Liquidator and T-Rex. Liquidator is a low frequency vertical shaker where we generate surface waves, like surface waves from earthquakes, but ours are linear typically, and earthquakes can be nonlinear. T-Rex is a triaxial shaker. Triaxial means that the shaker only one at a time, it can shake vertically, it can shake horizontally, and it can go transverse. It can go up to about 60,000 pounds force vertically and about half horizontally.
The T-Rex is on a fairly low setting right now, but don't worry, we're going to be turning it up shortly. It doesn't feel like much here right now, but we'll get there. And you might think this would just be used for destructive tests or validating computer models. No, this is useful for research and exploration.
We have been all over the United States. We have sensors that we've designed and we will push in because they're pushing rams on the back of Liquidator and T-Rex so that we can install sensors and then watch the wave go down. Many times we're watching the wave propagate away from us, but other times it's very helpful to have watch the wave going down and seeing how poorly the soil might behave due to large amplitude shaking, which is what you don't want.
We've now switched to horizontal shaking, and this is about half of what the T-Rex can do. I've only ever been in an earthquake once in my life, it was very slight, but it felt like this, the ground underneath my feet, the things you mentioned rely on. Right now, it just isn't stable anymore.
We just came back from Wyoming, where they're gonna build new power plants, and the earthquake design is critical, and we generated a 6,000 foot long wave. Now we generated a 2 foot long wave too, but going through the range. So that means we could evaluate the stiffness profile down to a half a mile with no boreholes. That is really a true accomplishment and a very, very cost-effective addition to the design of the plant. So this is a sensor. It's a big magnet with a coil. The coil's going through the magnetic field. We were out there in Wyoming and the darn cows walked by. Fortunately, they didn't break any cables, but we had to stop testing because they made more noise. They were right out there and we were a half a mile away.
And this is the highest setting that the team were allowed to use here on campus. As it's just show off what we can do. 27 tons of force being pushed to the ground. Only 10 times a second hit from 30, it turns out. Doesn't show up on a 30-second camera, and the world is shaking.
Oh my goodness, every time we go someplace, we'll make sure the level won't damage structures. Once we were on the UCLA campus and maybe didn't watch what we were doing so much, and people came running out of the building, and that got us in trouble.